Nihad Awad is the Executive Director of the Council on American Islamic Relations. He joins me now from Washington, D.C. Thank you for talking with us and at this very difficult time for your community.
Thank you for having me.
So what we know so far is that four Muslim men have been killed in Albuquerque, New Mexico over the last 9 months, and police say these murders are likely linked. Now, your organization, CAIR, is offering a reward for any information that could help lead to the arrest of the New Mexico shooter who's targeting these men. Have you received any tips that have helped in any way track down the perpetrator?
But the only tip that we know and the police has shared with people last night was about a car of interest. And we have ourselves broadcast that image along with the entire U.S. media. And we appreciate if the public comes forward, especially those who have information about this car, to participate in putting an end to this nightmare to our community and to the entire city and state in New Mexico. I mean, it's an important positive lead, and this does not impact, Rosemary, the Muslim community alone. It impacts all of us as Americans, and we should all be united against any acts of violence against innocent people. The precious lives who have been murdered senselessly in the past 9 months were known to be productive, active members of the community. Nothing but praise people have said about them. And we really have, we owe it to them and to all people to make sure that there is no criminal at large on the loose while we as communities and federal and local agencies have the potential to work together and put this individual or individuals behind bar.
And so your organization has also called on the Biden administration to order an all-hands-on-deck federal response and to ensure law enforcement have sufficient resources to stop these attacks. Is this investigation receiving the level of attention that you and your community have requested?
Well, you know, to be honest with you, I watched yesterday the statement by the governor, by the mayor, by the chief police in Albuquerque. So many important local and federal agents have really taken this matter very seriously, and we appreciate this. It means a lot to American Muslims, especially to the small community in Albuquerque. And we urge the Biden administration to provide more manpower, more resources to help the local agencies to identify the suspect and arrest him or them immediately and put this nightmare to an end.
Do you believe these four men were targeted because of their religion or race?
Well, the police and the investigators have told us that so far they believe that these murders are linked. They're linked because the victims share the same heritage or different heritage but the same religion. Maybe same ethnicities, three of the four. So we do not know the motivation behind these killings, but we know one thing, that they have been murdered, they're innocent people, and there's someone there killing them randomly, but also in an organized fashion, you know, the ambush. So the police have a lot more than we do. They know a lot more than we do, and they themselves believe that, you know, it is because of their faith, it is because of who they are. So we're not saying this, the local officials are coming to that conclusion.
And what impact is this having on the Muslim community in Albuquerque?
As I said, it is a small community. It has a long history in the state, but also there are recent refugees and immigrants there who are trying to make Albuquerque their home and their future. And definitely the community is terrified. People are scared for their lives, for their loved ones. Many people report that they don't go out even to do the necessary stuff like shopping or even, you know, visiting or taking care of necessary stuff. So we urge them to not be taken by fear. And the local local law enforcement is providing safety, also measures and escorts. So while we understand how terrified our community in Albuquerque and even beyond nationwide, we will not allow this to control us. And, you know, we're not going to be victims. We're strong. We are faith-based community. And all of us as Americans are united and should be united.
Nihad Awad, thank you so much for talking with us.
Thank you.